Bryce Dask, good morning, welcome.
Good morning, thank you so much, man.
I mean, you're one of those versatile guys that you are good at singing, you play the guitar, you're funny, you have this improvisational skill really seems to tickle people's funny bone. Which love started first?
I definitely discovered music first. I remember my favorite track, it was a hot banger. When I was about 1 year old, it used to go, Old MacDonald. Yay, man. That thing used to get me.
Which part of it?
The E-I-O. You know the E-I-O. Yeah, yeah, yeah. We all used to just...
And it can go on for hours, too.
We did go on for hours. That thing was a banger. Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star, I think, was the next hit single. Okay. And then I started getting into the, you know, Ba Ba Black Sheep. That was hot. Yeah. The remix was amazing. But, so it was definitely music first. And then comedy came much later.
At what point did you know that you had an audience? Because did it start at home in the lounge, like with everybody, or was it in front of an actual audience? Or
my first comedy audience was actually millions of people on a TV show called So You Think You're Funny. It was on SABC 1. David Gao was pretty much like idols for comedians. Mm. And I'd never done comedy before. I saw the ad and I was like, let me try it. So literally the first time I performed was in front of three judges, but with millions of eyes looking at me. And I guess I did well enough to get through. I got kicked out in the top eight. Mm. And the only reason why I carried on is because they called me back for the final to be a guest performer, because I use the guitar when I do comedy. For sure. That's when I thought maybe I've got something that's a little to the left if they call me
back. And here's the amazing thing. Nobody can remember who the winner was.
No. I'm sure some people do. He's my friend and a very funny guy. It's Fiso Nene, people.
Okay, there we go.
It's Fiso Nene.
Let's talk about this competition, because how tough was it? Because obviously you've been presenting TV. Yeah. You've been doing so many things at the highest level in South Africa. Why enter the competition?
Because you never really know until you know. Like in theory, I think as an artist, you think your stuff is good. You believe your stuff is good. But you never really know until you go out there. You might say that your music or your comedy is world standard. But until you actually, you know, measure it up, you'll never know. So when I saw the advert for the Switzerland Festival, I was like, this is my chance to actually see if comedy really is universal. Mm. It's not America. It's not the UK. It's Switzerland. So it was kind of the challenge of, if comedy really is universal, then I can make French-speaking, German-speaking, Switzerland people laugh. And it worked out.
Was that one of the reasons? That was the fact-finding mission for you?
Yes.
Yeah. That was the thing at the end of the day. And so they hand you first prize. You're the winner. You're an international comedian.
Yeah.
So what goes through your mind?
Do you know what's funny? Like, I remember we were on our way from the plane. We were in a car with an American act, and we were talking comedy, what comedy is like in America and what comedy is like in South Africa. Obviously much smaller in South Africa. So we're telling him how we do things here. And he obviously had a picture of how good we were based on what we were telling him. I remember the first time he saw us perform, because I was up there with a guy named Loiso Madinga, funny guy. The first time he saw us perform, he comes to us. You know when someone's congratulating you, but you can see in their eyes, they can't believe what they just... It was like he saw unicorns doing stand-up comedy. You know when someone's like, hey, yo, dude, you cats from Africa. Like, people don't believe...
Yeah, like you're funny.
Because we're working so hard, like in
like
our
you
own...
saw unicorns,
dude. Seriously, because it's like we're in South Africa, bottom of Africa, and we're doing our thing, you know? Even the guys, OB and the band, are doing their thing. And the world has no idea that we're putting in the hours. So the first time they see us, they like, I can't believe that these guys are this good. Yeah. Because they just don't know that we're grinding down here.
What is it? I think, and I'm going to put it out there, I think comedy is hard as it is. But when you include an instrument, people, I think it's a little bit, it makes it harder. And I sometimes think people think it's easier because that is your little, your crutch. But I think it's harder because you have to find a rhythmical way.
You have to find a rhythmical way. You have to try and find how to say it musically. But once you get that, it becomes easier, because I find that people accept things when you sing them as opposed to just saying them. Mm. Like if I go, do you see how beautiful that sounded? Yeah. That was like, it was like, ooh.
I expected the rose off.
No, it was like, what kind of AIDS is this? This, oh, wow. because I sang it. But okay. When you say AIDS, then people are like, oh, what is that? So once you get the technique of it, and you then music can really help you get and those hard messages across.
It's got nothing
across.
To do with the physicality of it as well. Because you're quite a physical performer too.
The thing is, stand-up comedy is performance. Mm. And in South Africa, we're only starting to grow in it because, you know, traditionally we just used to, you speak, I speak, you listen. Mm. But definitely, once you start adding the moves and start adding the performance elements of it, it becomes alive.
5 seconds. Are we going to see a square off ever between you and Deep Fried Man?
Never. Deep Fried Man is my boy.
I think that would be funny.
South Africans love drama.
I think people would pay for that. Maybe you should work that out. Maybe a venue, the two of you, square
we'll
off.
We'll come back next year sometime.
I think so. Awesome, that's we're going to leave it there. But thank you very much for joining me. Of course, he's the winner of the 2014 English Montreux Comedy Contest finale winner. He's an international comedian now. You've got to pay top dollar to see him. The competition is...
Dollar, Baba. Dollar. Dollar.
Top dollar.
Tell
them
again.
This,
do
man.
That link again.
You've
that was beautiful.
You've got to pay top dollar to see that. Nkonzo, he's an dollar. International comedian.
Dollar.
There's $1.
Okay. Hey, dollar. Dollar.
We're going to take an ad break when we come.